Holmes won his first 48 professional bouts, including victories over Ken Norton, Muhammad Ali, Ernie Shavers, Mike Weaver, Jerry Cooney, Tim Witherspoon, Carl Williams, and Marvis Frazier.
So many people said, I can't do this, I would never be Ken Norton, I'd never be heavyweight champion of the world.
Holmes' left jab is often rated among the best in heavyweight boxing history.
I like the movement, I like the height, I like the arm reach.
In addition to holding the WBC heavyweight title from 1978 to 1983, Holmes held the Ring Magazine and Lineal heavyweight titles from 1980 to 1985 and the inaugural IBF heavyweight title from 1983 to 1985.
Stalking, Holmes dancing, lots of movement. A good blow by Holmes, a good right!
Undefeated heavyweight champion Larry Holmes defends his crown for 13th times against Randall Cobb in the challenger's home state of Texas.
You're a great champ.
I want Don to tell you how great I am because I don't suppose to do it.
Cobb's record was fair enough, 20-2, with victories over Ernie Shavers and Bernardo Mercado and a very questionable loss to Kenny Norton.
Fighting, I don't care what the work is.
And while he dropped a 10-round decision to Michael Doakes, now the number one contender, he had Doakes in big trouble.
It was a real good fight, and like I say, I learned a lot. And partner, I'm going to be back. We're going to do this again.
The fight, that took place 42 years ago today, saw Cobb prove that toughness, desire, and a hell of a sturdy chin can see a man so badly outclassed see it through all 15 rounds against a fine champion if he really wants it enough. Cobb, though, despite being so badly beaten, was just getting going, as a chat show guest to die for, as a movie actor, and as the man who arguably gave his sport some of its most memorable.
Anybody, he doesn't feel he has to do that anymore. That was a strong right. Larry Cobb as well, picks off punches beautifully. Second round is counting down, and you saw all in rapid combination. And the end of round two at so far, the Clint wanted to have it out with Roger Staubach. More than halfway through the third round, Cobb keeps missing. There, a right got into the of Holmes against Scotland.
Cobb's plan was to jab powerfully to the body, over and under the heart, which is what fighters do when their jabs are too slow to go to the head.
Low, but lately in combination, the right is good. Cobb scored well. Of rights and a touch wobbly, the man who's from the right nostril, particularly Larry Holmes, just gives a boxing lesson. Look at that combination. Pretty thing to see. Other boxing deaths in the past and the lesson.
Another Cobb stratagem was to counter whatever Holmes threw. It's awfully hard to counter punch effectively against a good left hand in movement.
If there's even an appearance of connection. Rightly, that really caught Cobb. about the degree of punishment. Ronaldo snipes it. An instant replay of each round.
Through the first eight rounds, Holmes paced himself as he ducked Cobb's heavy but ponderous punches, jabbing on the run, only occasionally boring in for a quick burst before moving on.
Utila slightly ended. Look at Holmes, just keeps pouring it on, and then suddenly...
The fight such as this. Cobb is taking a tremendous lead.
Roared, and you saw Holmes. His pattern. He'll keep using that left as he means too much to him. It seems to me somebody should think about the degree of punishment. Space swallowing. This is brutal.
Holmes, setting up thunderous overhand rights and vicious left hooks with his still great left jab, left Cobb's face a mess.
That he had Holmes, he was punching him. The fans cheer like it's effective. Yes, Randy. Rounds.
Despite the constant pounding, Cobb would not fall and became only the second man in 13 challenges for Holmes's World Boxing Council title to last 15 rounds. Eyes were cut during the fight, and both were purple-colored slits afterward, and the challenger's nose and lip were bloodied, and there were scrapes all around.
Boxing, which is under fire, this fight could not have come at a worse time.
The 234-and-a-quarter-pound Cobb, suffering his third loss against 20 victories, his punches did not seem to even annoy Holmes.
From the mere thud of Holmes's left. This referee has no intention of stopping this fight. I wonder if that referee understands.
For the first 90 seconds of the 15th, Holmes tried to stay away from the still charging Cobb.
And he certainly doesn't want to inflict pain.
Finally, in self-defense, he was forced to fight back.
It's outrageous.
We had a couple strategies going into the fight. We had keep going, you know, his legs gonna go.
Yeah.
He can't take this pace, man.
Right.
The winner by unanimous decision and still undefeated world heavyweight champion, Larry Holmes.